Good morning, K3B students. How are you today? How could you going with your reading? On this video, we're going to read and practice how to tell a story and to how to read a rhymes. Okay, welcome back to a new lesson. Our lesson today is telling a story and rhymes. Okay, so before that, we're going to read the previous stories that we had and also some poems that we had last week and yesterday. Okay, please prepare yourself. Do not open your book yet. You have to listen carefully. Okay, so we have to focus on reading. And I know you are excited to write, but please bear in mind that reading is more important. Okay, so please listen, especially to the words that it's not easy to read. Okay, so please look at here. I'm going to read the acrobats. The acrobats. I'll swim by my ankles, she'll cling to your knees as you hang by your nose from a high up trapeze. But just one thing, please, as we float through the breeze, don't sneeze. Okay, one more. Please try to listen the words that have long sound and with consonant blends, okay? So listen carefully and please don't forget. Okay, ready? The acrobats. I swing by my ankles, she'll cling to your knees as you hang by your nose from a high up trapeze. But just one thing, please, as we float through the breeze, don't sneeze. Okay, so please master this poem and we go to the story, okay? So this is story of the clever hen. All right, remember this? Okay, so remember the word that's not easy for you to read. Please practice reading, okay? So, the clever hen. Number one, I had a little hen, the prettiest ever seen. She washed me the dishes and kept the house clean. She went to the mill to fetch me some flour. She brought it home in less than an hour. She baked me my bread, she brewed me my ale. She sat by the fire and told many a fine tale. The word that's not easy for you to read was this one. The word with Eddie, okay? So I told you again before that if it's not letter T and letter D with AD, you should not stress the word ed, okay? This is a silent AD, okay? Because this word is already a past tense. It means it's already finished, okay? She washed. Wash, not washed. Wash. She washed me the dishes. Okay, this one is dishes. Dishes. And kept the house clean. She went to the mill to fetch me some flour. She brought it home in less than an hour. She baked only bake, not baked, okay? She baked me my bread, and brood me my ale. This is a long O, brood, okay? She sat by the fire and told many a fine tale. This is your mistake here. The word fire and fine. Always remember the long sound I, okay? It's not fear, but fire. And this one is fine tale. Remember the words with long sound, okay? So we had already finished that lesson, so you have only thing for you to do that is to remember, okay? So I want you to practice this today, okay, to the poem and the storytelling. Okay, so later we're going to read a story again and also rhymes, okay? So I will give you some guidelines later, how to read a story and how to read rhymes, okay? So please read this. I give you 10 minutes to practice this. Then send me your voice message. I will check if you know how to read the whole poem, the acrobats, and also the story of the clever hen. Okay, so I'll be back after a few minutes. Okay, thank you for your cooperation on reading, and I was very, very happy because most of you can read the two stories, okay? So now I'm going to introduce to you our lesson. A rich man lives in his ranch and an old woman who lived in a shoe, okay? It is a story and this is a rhymes. Okay, so here and reading a story, you have to note the consonant blends. Okay, look at the words with consonant blends, if there is. Okay, also note the words and its ending sounds. Okay, some words here has CS ending sound and SH ending sound. Okay, so also remember the sight words. There are a lot of sight words there. Please try to practice reading them. All right, on reading a story, you are going to note also how to pause, how to stop, okay? So here, remember the word, the period, you're going to stop, okay? So please remember this sign or period, you're going to stop reading, okay? So I'm going to read first. Listen carefully, okay? So the same here, in reading rhymes, you have to see the word with consonant blend, word with long sound, and also the sight words. Okay, so remember the word with ed, like whip. Okay, so please remember our reading pattern, okay? All right, so let's start here. This story, you can find this in your book at page 226, okay? You're going to open your book later. But this time you have to listen carefully, okay? So here, a rich man lives in his ranch. He has a batch of helpers in the ranch. He always wants a big lunch. His cook bake him a cake and fish dish which he loves. Okay, remember the word lives. Okay, so sorry because I know this is this word have two vowels, but this one it is as we call that there are some words that we consider as sight words. Okay, lives. This is lives. It's not lies. Okay, leaves, ranch, ending to ranch, ranch, batch, batch, ranch, lunch, and punch. Okay, this one is helpers, helpers, always, bake, cake. So there are things that you have to consider on your reading, okay? So I hope that after this lesson, you're able to read this story and also these rhymes, okay? So I will read again. Please listen carefully because you're going to read by yourself later. A rich man lives in his ranch. He has a batch of helpers in the ranch. He always wants a big lunch. His cook bake him a cake and fish dish which he loves. Okay, please remember the period here. Okay, so there are a lot of period. We call it period. That is time to stop. Okay, so when you read, you have to read like this. A rich man lives in his ranch. Okay, do not stop along with these words, okay? You just stop when you see period. This is period. A rich man lives in his ranch. Then continue again. He has a batch of helpers in the ranch, period. He always wants a big lunch, period again. His cook bake him a cake and fish dish which he loves. And this is period. Okay, so one more. Let's practice reading. Observe how when to stop. Okay, so remember this period, you have to stop. Okay, one more time. You read with me. Okay, I will ask you to open your book at page 226. Please underline the period there, okay? All right, page 226, let's read together. Are you ready? Okay, a rich man lives in his ranch. He has a batch of helpers in the ranch. He always wants a big lunch. His cook bake him a cake and fish dish which he loves. This is loves, okay? So after reading this one, you're going to answer the question here. Where does the man live? Where does the man live? Okay, you can see here, where does the man live? The man live in the blah, 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 okay? So number two, who live with him in the ranch? Number three, what dish does he love? This is the food, okay? So you are going to answer this after reading the story. Just read the story first. I will give you time to do your activity, okay? So, okay, let's move to these rhymes, okay? So remember again the period or comma, we call this comma. You're going to pause or stop for a moment and then continue reading. Observe this period, you have to stop, okay? Stop. All right. So this old woman who live in a shoe. Okay. So woman. So this is, there are two syllables here. Woman. And again, this word ended with eddie. So this is live in a shoe. She had so many, this is long sound, remember this. Many children, she didn't know what to do. She gave, this is a long sound, she gave them some broth without any bread. Then whip them soundly, and put them to bed. If she had just two, should be period, she could make them a stew. Stew is a long sound O, okay? Stew is long sound O, stew. The spelling is different, but it is ending sound U. And sent them to school in pretty, pretty jackets of blue. Okay, so please listen carefully. There was an old woman who lived in a shoe. She had so many children, she didn't know what to do. She gave them some broth without any bread, then whipped them soundly and put them to bed. If she had just two, she could make them a stew and send them to school in pretty jackets of blue. Okay, so if you listen to these rhymes, you can see or you can hear the two words that have the same sound. Okay, like shoe and do have the same sound. Okay, and then two and stew have the same sound. And also two and blue have the same sound. Okay, so let's read again because you're going to read by yourself after this. Okay. So, read with me. There was an old woman who lived in a shoe. Stop, because there is comma. She had so many children, she didn't know what to do. She gave them some broth without any bread, then whipped them soundly and put them to bed. If she had just two, she could make them a stew and send them to school in pretty jackets of blue. These rhymes can be also a song, okay? You can sing this song, you can also recite as rhymes, okay? So let's read again. So remember the word that's not easy to read: woman, live, children, know, give, broth, bread, whip, soundly, chew, could, stew, school, pretty, jackets, blue. Okay, so let's read again. There was an old woman who lived in a shoe. She had so many children, she didn't know what to do. She gave them some broth without any bread, then whipped them soundly and put them to bed. If she had just two, she could make them a stew and send them to school in pretty jackets of blue. Okay, so please practice reading this two stories, to this story. And also these rhymes or song. This is also song, it can be rhymes. Okay? So I will give you 10 minutes to practice reading this rhymes and story. Okay? So as I have told you, we will focus on reading. Okay? So maybe a few more months you will be in grade 1. So that's why I challenge you to please practice reading. Okay, if you cannot read the words here, please circle. Okay, so after you copy these songs or rhymes, you're going to circle the words that you cannot read. Okay, for example, you forgot to read children. Teacher, I don't know this one. Okay, circle. I don't know broth. I don't know this one. You circle. I don't know this one, so you're going to circle. Then we're going to practice again before I give you your homework, okay? So, even here, even this story, if you don't know how to read the word lunch, teacher, I don't know this, okay? Teacher, I don't know this. All right, just circle the words that you cannot read, okay? So I give you 10 minutes or more. Then after that, please send me your voice message for checking and giving your scores, okay? So I'll be back after a few minutes. Okay, I'm back for your activity 1 and activity 2. Okay, so please listen carefully so that you know what to do. Okay, so for your task 1, you're going to read the story again and answer the questions below. Number 1 question is, where does the man live? For example, if I will ask you, where do you live? I live in Nampintamay. So here, we ask the man where he live, okay? So where does the man live? Okay, a rich man lives in his ranch. So again, so along this story, you can see the answer here, okay? So number 2, who live with him in the ranch? Okay, who are the people with him? Okay, so he has a batch of helpers in the ranch. He always wants a big lunch. His cook baked him a cake and fish dish which he loves. Along the story, you can find who are the people with him. Okay, so who live with him in the ranch? Number 3, what dish does he love? So what dish means dish, it is the food that she or what that he loved to eat. Okay, what dish does he love? He loved to eat what? Okay, you're going to find the answer here. Okay, this is your task number 1. Okay, you have to understand the story so that you can answer these questions. Okay, for the task number 2, you are going to read again these rhymes or song and answer this one, okay? Alright, for example, here, this is task number 2. This is your task number 2. Yep. The instruction here is this. Write the missing words. Means that you are going to read this and write the missing words here. Okay, for example, number 1, there was an old woman who lived in a, you're going to find here, okay? Then number 2, she had so many blank, she didn't know what to do. Alright, number 3, blank, give them some blank, without any bread. Number 4, then whip them blank and blank them to blank. Okay, you read here. Number 5, if blank had just blank, she blank make them a blank. Number 7, and blank them to blank in blank jackets of blank. Okay, as I have told you, read this again so that you can answer this activity number 2. Okay, so I give you time to copy this. Please copy carefully and read carefully so that you can answer these questions or activity. Alright, so I give you 15 minutes to do it. Copy this story or copy these rhymes and answer this activity. Okay, so I'll be back after 15 minutes. Okay, for this video, I'm going to give you your homework. Please listen carefully. You're going to use your new book at page 124 and 125. Okay, so this is absolutely a review for the lesson that we had. Okay, so here, and number one, at page 124, trace the letter O in the short vowel sound and read. Number two, trace the letters O and E in the long vowel word. Okay, at page 124. Okay, you are going to read the short sound and the long vowel sound. Okay? So, at page 125, you're going to write the missing letters to complete the long O words. Okay? So, please try to read this to enhance your reading. Okay? So, please do your homework. And I will check this on Thursday. Okay? So, enjoy your activities. Thank you for your cooperation. Please practice your reading. I will listen to you again on Thursday. You have to read the rhymes. There was an old woman. Okay? So please copy this one because this is one of your homework. Okay? So thank you again and see you on Thursday.